So when I was looking to put a propane system in my van, I was kind of surprised to find that there aren't a whole lot of regulations as to how you need to store the propane. It seems like when you're self-converting a camper van, you're kind of in a weird gray area here, at least in terms of like US and Canadian law. And basically all they say is that you need to keep the canister upright and that you can't have more than like 100 pounds of propane in your vehicle. And for context, this is a 5 pound tank that I have here. So, what people do seem to agree on though is that it is good practice to have a propane locker. And to give you some fundamentals on a propane locker, it's basically just a sealed box with a hole in the bottom. Because propane is heavier than regular air, if there is a leak, the gas will just seep out the hole. And I wanted to find some like standards for building a box, and the American Boat and Yacht Council has some standards that they put out, and they say that a propane locker must be top load. So this is a side load box. So as you can see, I didn't follow their recommendation at all for this. And they also say that the vent at the bottom of the locker needs to be at minimum 3/4 of an inch in diameter. And I'm using a McDonald's straw, so I'm not following any of their recommendations here. This is what I think should probably work okay. And I'm not too worried about it because I think, at least in my mind, the most problems I've had with propane and propane accessories are what is attached to the tank. So like the flexible hose and the regulator. And really what it comes down to is if you forget to turn your tank off after you're done cooking or whatever, then it doesn't matter what kind of box you have because your whole propane system is live, and then a leak can happen anywhere, and I really think that that's what causes the majority of explosions. It should be said though that every propane tank does have a pressure release valve, and this will release pressure even if your main valve is closed, right? And this typically doesn't happen because filling stations are regulated and they only fill them to 80% of maximum capacity. But in a hot car, or due to other circumstances like changes in elevation, you can have this emergency relief valve venting propane. And that's why you build the locker. That's the whole point of this. But really, your biggest safety consideration in my mind is to remember to turn off this silly valve when you're done cooking, which I know I'm going to forget to do. And to make that easier, I put yet another side hatch. Sorry, American Boat and Yacht Council. And this allows me to reach in and turn this on and off without getting out of my van. So that's why I built this the way I did. Also notice that there's kind of a high lip here because it is really hard to get a seal on a door. And at least towards the bottom, I don't want to be relying on any sealing surface. So the box has a lip around it. Hopefully the propane will pool in there and then vent out this hole. And the hole is actually not in the middle of the box. It's off center to the side here. And I don't know if that's going to make a difference either. So this isn't a how-to tutorial. I'm not an expert. I'm just showing you what I built and why I'm comfortable with how it's set up in my van. So anyways, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. All right, I feel like I need to address a couple more points here. One, there's no lid. Yeah, there's supposed to be a lid on propane lockers. Obviously, it's supposed to be a sealed container. I'm still working out how this is going to fit in with other stuff in my build, so the lid's not done yet. Yeah, I'm putting an incomplete project on YouTube. That's never happened before. And yeah, also if you're worried about the propane safety stuff, there's all kinds of things that you can spend money on. You can buy leak detectors, you can buy solenoid valves, so you can just flip a switch and cut off your tank. You can do external tanks mounted underneath the body of the vehicle. There's different pass-through grommets and hoses and fittings, and you could really go nuts with it. The way I'm justifying being cheap is that I have a simple setup with a small tank, and I'm going to try to be diligent and keep an eye on things. Famous last words, I'll probably die in a fiery explosion. So who knows?